Don't ask me what you know is true. Don't have to tell you I love your precious heart.
We are here today for a very specific and sacred reason, to remember and to celebrate the life of Riley Huckaby and to show our love and support for Amy. So welcome. We're glad you all could be here. Let's pray together. Gracious and loving God, it is good to know that in you we find reasons to celebrate. We celebrate the life of this wonderful man, Riley. We celebrate that in you we have the promise of eternal life, so we don't have to grieve as those without hope. We celebrate a precious family and dear friends. We celebrate the strength that comes from drawing together. Let your peace and your gladness rest on us, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
One of my favorite scriptures is the 121st Psalm, and the reason I like it is because it asks a question, but then it also gives us the answer. I lift mine eyes to the hills. From where comes my help? We ask that question sometimes, don't we? How will I make it? Where is my help? But here's that answer. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. So the sun shall not smite you by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. The Lord will keep your life. The Lord will keep your coming and your going for now and forevermore. I know some of you have had the privilege at New Covenant to meet our music director, Sean Pollock, and he's going to bring his first song for us now.
To everything.
time to rend, a time to sow, a time to love, a time to hate, a time for peace. I swear it's not too late.
Scriptures that might be appropriate. One of the very first ones that came to my mind was from the book of John, from the 10th chapter. Jesus said, "I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly." And when we think of Riley's life and the fact that y'all are here, I think that's certainly an example of what we're meaning by the idea of an abundant, of a blessed, of a full life. I know we all can be grateful for that. I like this passage from the book of John, from the 14th chapter. "Don't let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, what if I told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to where I am." And so because that is true, we hear these words later on in that same chapter. "Peace I leave you, peace I give you. Not like the world gives, give I unto you. So don't let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." Peace in all times and all situations. And that is something we too can celebrate. And from the 23rd Psalm, and I hope for many of us this is a psalm that we find comforting and very, very familiar. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul." And we can take that breath and feel that peace because our soul gets restored. "He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you, God, are with me. Your rod and your staff comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anoint my head with oil and my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever."
Thank you.
heaven, but I've been told, coming for to carry me home. The streets in heaven are paved with gold, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Coming for to carry me.
Beautiful. When I have the honor to share a few remarks to reflect on a person's life and what that might mean and how that fits with our faith and what might just especially reflect that, I was trying to think of scriptures that would really fit for Riley. And finally, this is the one I came up with. So, Amy, I hope this makes sense as we go through this. It's from a psalm, from Psalm 90, verse 12. So teach us to number our days so we may apply our hearts to wisdom. There's a lot of good advice in that prayer from the psalm. So teach us to number or to order, to organize our days so we may apply our hearts to wisdom. And the reason I think that's appropriate is because it really reflects how Riley lived his life, how he planned, how he worked so hard, and how he persevered in so many times, in so many ways, and how he was persistent. That and what a heritage you leave behind that people could say that about you. He started out in kind of the unique situation of being a Baptist preacher's kid. Well, I wasn't a preacher's kid, but I had one. So I know that that can be pretty challenging right there. And so he had to kind of figure what that all out was going to mean for him and live through that. And as he continued to grow up in that home and begin to find his own gifts and his own abilities, one thing that was certainly a constant in him was his skill and his love of sports, and that served him well all the way through school, including to the fact that he even got a football scholarship. And that love and everything that took to be part of sports, including the planning and the hard work and the perseverance, passed that on to the boys and how much he loved seeing them. The hard work and the persistence that went into his career as a pipe fitter, not an easy job, one that took hard work and effort and persistence, but he did it well. But as he began to live his life with Amy and in his career and with his kids and all the things that he did, he began to show more and more how he really had that planned and that wise heart in all that he did, so much so that for one reason you, his friends, are here just to honor and rejoice in how he lived his life for you. One friend said he was a true gentleman, a true Southern gentleman. He was the kind of person that let his actions speak louder than his words. Not a very common trait in our society today, is it? But he was able to do that. When your actions can speak louder than words, you have nothing to prove. You're simply living true to what you believe, to what you value, and to what you trust. Everybody who met him said, what a great smile and what a friendly person. I can think of few things more significant than to be remembered that way. He was able to be that loving and that thoughtful and that kind person, even living in a divided home between Gamecocks and Clemson. I don't get that. Somebody obviously had a love and patience and forgiveness. I don't think I could have done that. So that's impressive all by itself. And let's not think, you know, he was all just about just being Mr. Sweet and Calm. Because you're all going to find out later how much he loved his music, how much he loved his rock and roll. And you're going to be able to hear some of that later. He loved with his sports, being also to play doubles, Amy to play tennis and to play pickleball. And I understand that's partly why y'all chose to move here, was so you could do that. And then most of you probably know when his health began to decline, he got into bowling, didn't he? Where he could still do things together with Amy and do things with friends and appreciate that. When I think of his part of the life here in the villages, that's where I think we really see how he ordered, how he numbered his days. Making the decision that y'all made to be able to retire early enough, not knowing what all of life ahead would hold and that his days would be much shorter than we wanted. What a gift he gave to both of you by ordering his days in such a way that you could fully benefit in the time you had left. That really is a life well lived. That really is a life well ordered. That really is a life that applies itself to have a heart of wisdom, like that passage said. That kind of wisdom is described in the book of James in the 3rd chapter like this. See who it sounds like. The wisdom that comes from heaven is pure, peace-loving, considerate, full of good fruit, and sincere. Those are the adjectives that describe Riley's life. And it came from the whole way he lived his life, applying and ordering his life in such a way that his heart would be applied to wisdom. There's another well-known passage that I think also could describe how that wisdom played out in Riley's life. You know we call this the love chapter. 1 Corinthians 13, love is patient, love is kind, love doesn't envy, doesn't boast, isn't proud, doesn't dishonor others, and is not self-seeking. Wow. That's Riley to a T. Not self-seeking, not boastful about himself, not envious, just living his life out, keeping no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. And finally, listen to this. Love always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. And he lived that even into his final days. The loving wisdom that his well-ordered life was all about was rooted in faith. And that becomes now his final gift to his family and to all of y'all, his friends. Because of a life rooted in faith, you're able to say, I can cherish every memory. I can be grateful for the life he lived. And when we share a life rooted that's in faith, we can say, we find out that even in mourning, as Matthew 5 in the Beatitudes says, even those who mourn are blessed. And we find out even now, because of a faith that we can share, the Spirit of the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who may be broken in spirit. Because of his life that was rooted in faith, I believe with all my heart, and this is part of his final gift to us, that Riley's already heard the words from Matthew 25, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord." That's why we can call today a celebration, because he has entered into the joy of the Lord, and the joy that was all part of his life, we can celebrate and appreciate together. So Riley, we say thank you for how you lived your life. To God, we say thank you that you created a man who could choose to live a well-ordered life with a heart of wisdom that was able to bless each and every one of us. Would you pray with me now? God, we trust in your promises that you are the God of all comfort. We trust that because of faith in you, we don't grieve as those without hope. But in fact, even in tears, we can still remember with gladness and we can even rejoice. Let peace and joy and grace and love be with us this day and in the days to come. Amen. Let's take a moment to have a word of blessing on our evening and on the food that's to come. Gracious God, for every good gift, we're thankful. We're thankful for this evening and this food. Bless it to our nourishment. Bless those who prepare it. Bless indeed this evening as a time of fellowship. Amen.
I believe that is the food all ready, folks? Almost ready. Almost ready. Well, hold on just a moment. And they're getting another table, so we'll have a table out. I'm so blessed I had more friends than I knew about. So I appreciate that. And I want to take this time while we're getting set up with the food to thank y'all for coming. I really, really appreciate it, and it means so much to me that every one of you are here. I just really appreciate it. And I'll go ahead and say, I was going to tell you this later, but since they're still setting up the food, I'll go ahead and tell you. Some of you noticed on the tables, a lot of you did not know Riley. You knew me, or you didn't know Riley very well. So with the help of a good friend of mine, Jan, we made some centerpieces to help you get to know Riley for those of you that didn't. So after dinner, you'll have a chance to get up and walk around to the other tables. And there's also something at Riley's table and at the dessert table. And take a moment and get to know him a little bit better. And if y'all take that table and put it on this side over here, because the music will be over there. So if you'll take time later to do that, that would be wonderful.
Later, but since we've got a few minutes now, I'm going to
hold on a second. This celebration of life was, not all of it, but most of it was planned by Riley. And he had several requests. Number one was that it was to be at Fish Hawk Recreation Center. So here we are at Fish Hawk Recreation Center. And the reason it was at Fish Hawk Recreation Center, because the best years of his retirement were spent on those courts over there playing pickleball. That is why he moved to the Villages. We came to visit on a lifestyle program, and the last day we were here, somebody said, "Have you ever played pickleball?" And he said, "No." He said, "Well, come meet me for some pickleball." Well, after that, he was a goner. We were never going to retire to Florida, but after that, we were retiring to Florida. So he spent some wonderful hours playing pickleball. And that was his favorite thing. And some of those of you that know, he was a very good pickleball player. Another thing he did that you'll get to hear once you get your food and sit down, there's some music that he picked out. And my son was pretty surprised with a lot of this music because it wasn't what we thought his favorites were. So, and he had put this on the computer. I knew that he had something, but I'd never looked at it. So we hadn't looked at this list of 9 songs until after he passed away. But he had picked them out. He first called them his final mix, and he kept changing them. But by the time he finished his typing, he wasn't very good at typing, and the final one says, "This is my final mix." So you're going to hear 9 songs throughout the evening, starting with a few while you're dining. And the reason he chose some of them was because they have a message to us. So some of them are fun songs, but some of them, especially the last 2 songs and a couple of the first songs, were songs that he wanted to leave a message to all of us. He had another request. Where's Ben? Right there. Ben? He wanted his close friend Ben Osborne, who he loved to listen to at various venues around the villages, to entertain you. So after dinner, Ben will be playing the guitar and singing for you. And I'm going to put in a plug for Ben. And on Friday, if you enjoy this so much, Friday night, come to where, Nancy?
Willie Jewel's.
Down by Everglades and Publix, down in the new section way south. And Ben will be entertaining there from 5 days. So, and he's also other places in the villages. But Riley loved to hear him play, and you'll get the honor to hear him play. He will be playing some of Riley's music tonight, too. And Riley was a classic rock lover. And the last request, and the most important request he had, was that he wanted this to be a party. He wanted us to celebrate him. So that means that you're to get up after dinner and everything, and we finish playing some of his songs. Get up, walk around, visit with everybody, check out the different tables to get to know him, listen to the music, there's an area out here, dance. Have fun. He wanted us to celebrate him, and the thing that would make me and him the happiest is that we were partying and celebrating. So please make sure you do that. Are we ready, ladies?
Hush now, don't you cry. Drop from your eye. You're lying safe in bed. It was all a bad dream spinning in your head. Your mind tricked you to feel the pain of someone close to you leaving the game. Another chance. Wide awake, you face the day. Your dream is over, or has it just begun? There's a place I like to. Child, you were there. silent lucidity. You